In Palau, there's a saying, lugelak langar. Lugelak langar means the environment is our life.
We live depending on nature itself, so we don't want to lose it. Orchids are very important because it goes hand in hand with all other organisms and species of trees in the environment. It tells us how healthy our forest ecosystem is and everything that surrounds it.
I think it's very important to learn more about the orchids of Palau because they're very unique to us. They're endemic and they're only found in Palau. Then we should know what we have.
Something as small as an orchid, just appreciating it and understanding it a little bit more just makes you feel so much more connected. Just expand your mind and expand your appreciation for everything out here.
The orchid family is the most diverse plant family on Earth. At the same time, orchid species are highly sensitive to environmental disturbances, and so we can use them as indicators of larger impacts that may be forthcoming. My name is Benjamin J. Crain. I'm an ecologist at the North American Orchid Conservation Center at the Smithsonian Environmental Research Center, and I'm working on the Palau Orchid Conservation Initiative. I'm fascinated by orchids and orchid science because of their overall diversity and just how unique and often strange orchid species can be. Palau is world-renowned for its marine biodiversity. However, it is also extremely diverse in terms of its forest ecosystems and its associated plant and animal communities. Palau Orchid Conservation Initiative focuses on fieldwork, laboratory work, education, and outreach to promote understanding of orchid ecology and conservation. Palauan people are uniquely passionate about their environment. The community is so entwined with their environment that it is just a pleasure to work with a group of people and a culture that is just enthusiastic about conservation.
It's important to protect the forest in Palau because every day we need plants to survive. We cannot live without plants. Every living thing in the forest, they have this connection, like they work together in order to the forest ecosystem intact. I see it as like gift from God.
Nice, huh?
That's a good specimen.
Yeah.
And we've got flowers, we've got fruits.
This one's really hard to find. All right, so a sampling. First thing I'm going to do is set up our labels. So as of now, this is our 905th site where we've recorded orchids in Palau. So what we're looking for is healthy, mature roots that are still alive. The mycorrhizal fungi is still in it, that we can extract the DNA from there. Okay. So there's the fruit. We'll dry this out and we'll take the seeds out and we'll freeze them in a seed bank, so to speak. And then what we'll do is, if we're successful getting the living mycorrhizal fungi out of this plant, we can try and germinate these seeds with the ultimate goal of being able to propagate plants that we can bring back to disturbed sites and restore the orchids if necessary.
Like many components of biodiversity, orchids are threatened by a number of environmental disturbances, including things like climate change and habitat loss. Orchid communities in Palau are representative of overall forest health, and forests are connected to a number of other ecosystems in Palau, including freshwater systems and marine systems. So by studying orchid communities, we can effectively understand how disturbances might be affecting not only forests, but also other aquatic and marine environments. By studying orchid communities in Palau, we can better understand the overall effects and needs of forest ecosystems on the island. And this in turn can help us develop more effective conservation strategies to prevent the loss of natural habitats and the resources they provide.
What really attracts me to the biodiversity of Palau is how much is left to be discovered. In order to protect a habitat, in order to protect a species, you have to recognize that it's there. And so getting a grasp of this biodiversity is first and foremost of paramount importance. Once we've identified not only the species, but the range and the habitats that they live in, then we can appropriately formulate protective legislation and measures to ensure that that never changes.
I think it's important to educate people of Palau about the biodiversity. It's part of us, it's part of our identity, who we are, what we have, and plus like knowledge that we pass on to the next generation.
Working with a Smithsonian has just been a godsend for us. Dr. Crain has introduced us to biodiversity that literally slipped our gaze. As a result of the Smithsonian's ability to educate us on our own backyard, we have visitors that come from all over the world, and now I'm able to introduce the world of orchids to them.
Working with the Smithsonian Institute has been very beneficial to our conservation areas. My personal hopes with the great biodiversity of Palau is to take care of our forests and our ecosystems.